up and damned him.
And whatever he does with our lives is going to be right. It's going to be right. Even now, after all these years, something will pop up in my life and I'll say to myself, that can't be right. And then here it comes again. When have you ever been right about it can't be right? Never. Never. Painful? Yes. Frightening? Absolutely.
Spit.
But he's always been right. He's always been right. So the more I know him, what's going to happen? The stronger and more confident I become in life. Well, do you know what he's decreed? No, don't have to. Because I know whatever he decrees will be right. Because he is right. Now, I want to go back to this. We've been talking about motivation, but I also want to talk about love. This is so very important. I shared this just a few days ago in another church in Grand Rapids. I see people, young people all the time, old people, everybody, in between people. I see them all lamenting the fact that they don't love God as they ought to. And I hear preachers telling them they don't love God as they ought. But what's the solution? I mean, what's the solution? Go to some wild Acquire the Fire conference and get all wound up like a little toy soldier for 3 days, and then you just wind down again and you're more angry than you were before. One more failed attempt at loving God. What do we do? I'm going to give you a physics lesson. I'm on the platform, I'm laying on my back, I've got both hands on my belt, and I'm pulling with all my might. You walk over and say, Brother Paul, what are you doing? I said, well, isn't it obvious? No. I'm trying to get up. You say to me, well, did you ever take physics in high school or college or anything like that? Why? Well, because in order to get up that particular way, you have to be acted on by an outside force. Someone firmly established outside of you with a strength greater than your mass must grab you by the belt and pick you up. You can't do it to yourself. Guess what? You can't make yourself love God more. You can't. No matter how many worship songs you listen to, you're not going to be able to do it. Well, you say, then how do I do it? I've been married for getting close to 30 years. I'm not the guy she married. I've gotten old. We were so young. Batman and Robin, that's who we were. Oh, I'm in a homeschool convention. I can't say that. I'm sorry. We were something. In the jungles and the mountains, and man, she's a beauty. Now we're slower, grayer. I left her today at home, and I was sad. More sad than when I used to leave her 25 years ago to go to some weird, dangerous place in the jungle. Now, the moment I tell you that I love my wife more now than I did then, I know what you're thinking, because you're not really that, but you're not very biblical. You're thinking, oh, what a wonderful man. He's such a wonderful man. I mean, do you hear the things he's saying? He loves his wife now more than he did when they were young and married. He loves her more now. He's such a wonderful man. Well, maybe not at all. Well, not maybe. I can assure you, I'm not. I'm just a normal man.
Dumbass.
See, when you see a man with an extraordinary love for his wife, maybe the man's just normal. Maybe it's his wife who's extraordinary. And she draws out his affections, even though his heart is as almost like a stone or a piece of clay. But her virtue, her beauty, her godliness can even draw affections out of that clod of dirt. When you see someone who loves God, you know, it just seems like they're on fire. And not just when they're preaching, but I mean, they're just going and going and going and going. What do you automatically think? Oh, what a wonderful person. There you go again. You're wrong again. I've read all those biographies, or a lot of them. None of them were very wonderful. Then what was it? They had a wonderful God. They had a beautiful God. And the beauty, the virtue, and the wonder, we could just go on and on and on, of their God drew out their affections.
I don't.
Yeah, but I thought I had a God like that. You do. Well, then what's the difference? They see more. They saw more of him than you do. Why? Let's go back to the guy in the ocean that's drowning. They needed him. They tried all kinds of different fountains in their life, most of them. And all of them were either dry, cracked cisterns, or polluted and left a stench on their lips. They knew that he alone has life, and the words of life. He alone can animate the heart. I mean, if there's anyone who can draw out your affections, it's got to be him. I knew that my mind, years ago, I knew that it was not exceptional. I knew that I wouldn't be a Renaissance man who would be able to just cover everything that's here. I made a decision that I would try to read the whole Bible all the time, but that I would study one thing. The cross of Christ. Would study one thing. To seek the cross in the Word, to seek the cross in prayer, the Christ of the cross. I get so angry at preaching. Writing, because he's so big and beautiful these words are stupid. He's beyond anything. Have you ever gone outside and seen a sunset or a sunrise and you walk out and you call your wife or something, you've got to see this, it'll take your breath away.
Let me report it to Black Astro Song, even if he is white.
But listen to me, young people, this fucking isn't bitch. This knowing him, it could start this evening, but it can't start and finish this evening. It is a lifetime of tracking out who Christ is.
Yeah. No.
Just going back, he says, present your bodies a living and holy sacrifice.
Does this one go on here?
A living sacrifice. Now, where I'm from, preachers are very common of saying, that's the problem, you know, dead sacrifices stay on the altar, living ones tend to want to crawl off. That's not the point here. The point is, this is not only a matter of right knowledge.
This is a nice pillow.
This is.
I need you to try to use two pillows to prop your feet up tonight, okay?
Okay.
A work of the Holy Spirit.
It'd be worth it.
Yeah.
Who regenerates us unto salvation.
Dude.
But then it's also
this
it's this continual relationship
the
with the Holy Spirit.
Do
you know what's wrong
really
with us?
He's
many
put,
of us,
in for
we've been robbed of our inheritance. I will tell you that.
And
at the risk of being criticized for it. We have been robbed of our inheritance. When I read the Puritans, when I read the Reformers, when I read the early Baptists and the early Presbyterian, the Dutch Reform guys, the early guys that didn't have to deal with so many heretical movements about the Holy Spirit, they could talk freely about the Holy Spirit and the fullness of the Holy Spirit and the power of the Holy Spirit. They could talk freely about the manifest presence of Christ in prayer. They could talk about all the things we're afraid to talk about because of our inheritance had been robbed from us.
He's going to be in a damn check.
By all these false movements that borderline on blasphemy with regard to the Holy Spirit. Young person, listen. You can't live the Christian life apart from the Holy Spirit. You can't live the Christian life just with Bible study.
Man,
you need prayer.
Is
more. It's so much more than intercession. Most of you, many of you, when you pray, it's all about the intercession. You need to divide your prayer time in two different stages. Prayer with your boots on and prayer with your boots off. Prayer with your boots on is you interceding, fighting, down in the trenches, crying out to God. There's nothing fun about that. And if that's all you do in prayer, you'll never be a person who prays. You need to pray with your boots off. Communion, crying out constantly. I will not back down on this. You need to cry out constantly for greater and greater and greater manifestations of the power and life of the Holy Spirit in you.
I fucked
to
this.
Live a godly life unto God. And that's what's lacking. Even people who have great knowledge,
he was truly
cannot apply that knowledge, even though they can write it on an examination. They cannot apply it because it's a work of the Holy Spirit.
He's being that whore.
It is more than material. It is more than knowledge. It is organic. It is life. It is power. And you need to seek Christ in the Word of God, but you need to seek Christ on your knees, never contrary to the Word of God. But on your knees. To know him.
Get that whore
his
out of here.
His life. His power. To know
damn
him.
Fucking whore.
To know him. And then he says a holy sacrifice. A holy sacrifice. One of the greatest things that has helped me with regard to the holiness of God is realizing the relationship between holiness and love. Holiness and love. Now let me explain.
It's right in ear his rook.
There is a kind, we can make two divisions in holiness. There is a kind of a moral aspect of holiness. Then there is a magisterial aspect of holiness. And you must understand the magisterial.
Stupid!
In its most confined root, holiness
that like a sack of shit.
Comes from the idea
stupid
of to
bitch.
Cut. And then to cut and to separate, as though my wife, when she's cutting vegetables like this, and then after making several cuts, then you see her take the blade and go like that, separate.
I just cut, ears.
Separate. The idea is separation. So when the Bible says that God is holy, first of all, do not think of it in terms of moral. Don't even look at it, first of all, in terms of sinlessness. Look at it, first of all, in terms of separateness. It's not that God is like us, just bigger, or God is like the archangels, just bigger. The idea is God is not like us at all. He is in a completely distinct category. There is no God and country, there's no God and king, it's God. The only time God belongs in a conjunctive relationship is when it is God the Father and God the Son and God the Holy Spirit. Any other time, no. He is in a category all to himself, and it is the highest category, infinitely above every other category. That's the first thing you need to understand. You must understand that. All right, then where do we go from here? Remember, I think I mentioned this, that one of the requirements of being a rational being is that you select the highest motivation for what you're doing. You have a reason for what you're doing, and that reason should be the highest. For example, if you see me in my pajamas standing out in the rain, about 100 meters from my house, and you say, Brother Paul, why are you standing outside in the rain in your pajamas at 3:00 in the morning? And I say, I don't know. That's irrational. There's a problem. But if you say, why are you standing out here at 3 in the morning in your pajamas in the downpouring rain? Because my house is on fire. That's rational. So,
no.
Here's what you need to see. God's love is tied to his rationale, his reason, his omniscience, his truth. God recognizes that he is infinitely above all other categories. God also recognizes that above all other beings, he is deserving of love. That he has the highest value. God recognizes that he has the highest value above all beings, and God recognizes he is most deserving of love. And in that category, you can say that above all things, God loves himself. And if it was any other way, he would be irrational. God is holy in that he is separated from all of his creation, and his love is upon himself, and rightly so. Now, what does it mean for you to be holy? It doesn't just mean you obey the rules. What does it mean that you are holy? It means that you recognize the same thing God recognizes. You recognize that God is in a category all to himself, infinitely above all categories. God is the most worthy of esteem, and God is the most worthy of love, and God is the most worthy of me laying down my life as a sacrifice. That's what it means to be holy. And then everything that our brother said previously falls in line underneath that. holiness begins with recognizing who God is. And the greatest revelation of who God is in the gospel of Jesus Christ. The more you know the gospel, the more you know who God is. The more you know who God is, if you are a believer, you will recognize that He is infinitely above all other categories. He is worthy of all esteem. He is worthy of all your love. And then everything else flows out of that. How is a man holy? How is a woman holy? They recognize God's infinite worth above all other things. They recognize that above all other beings, God is deserving of love. And so when they give themselves to God, they are only doing, the King James is wonderful here, they are only doing that which is rational service, reasonable service. It is not reasonable to lay down your life for a man. Even if you lay down your life for a nation and make it strong for an entire generation, wicked men will come behind you and destroy what you have built. It's not reasonable. There's only one true reason. There's only one pure logic. That is to lay down your life for Him, for God, for Christ.
Fucking bitch.
But don't go out that door all wound up like a toy soldier. Go out there, that door, committed to seeking His face. I'm going to end just by, I would love to get to verse 2, but we're going on quite long, but
son of a bitch.
I have studied the scriptures since I was converted, and that ranks above all books. If you spend more time in other books, you're in trouble. This is the book.
Suck my dick, bitch. This is the book. Bitch.
But no. But I can actually tell you.
Suck my dick, bitch.
It's funny because Dr. Beakey asked me about if I knew about, you know, if I'd read anything, I think this afternoon, about Ernie, from Ernie Reisinger or whatever, and I just didn't have time to answer him, but I just kind of chuckled inside, because he was where the journey began. And what I'm trying to say is, I have studied scripture, but wisdom was not born with me. Wisdom will not die with me. This book is bigger than 1,000 lifetimes of Paul Washer. If the greatest scholars, if 70... It's be like the Septuagint. If 70 of the greatest scholars that ever lived all came together and studied this book for 200 years, they wouldn't even scratch the surface. So not only do I need to study the scriptures, I need my brethren, because theology is always to be done in the context of the church. I need my brothers and sisters in Christ. I need people to talk to me about the Bible. Not anybody, but those who have a passion for Christ and truly believe that the Bible is the infallible, inerrant Word of God. And so, when I was a young man, had read nothing but basically liberal people and modern people because of the seminary I went to, and then in Peru, came across Today's Evangelism by Ernest Reisinger. Read it. Struck me to the core. I realized that as a matter of fact, without being dramatic, I remember just laying on my face after reading that book on this old dirty floor in Peru, thinking, oh Lord, spare me, and I promise I'll never preach the gospel the way I've preached it again. And then it was Ernie Reisinger, and then it went from there to Spurgeon, and then someone sent me The Holiness of God from R.C. Sproul. And I remember putting that, I had a little TV set about this big with one of those big cassette players at the bottom of it. You old guys know what that's like. And I remember sitting in this old plastic chair, and I was sitting back, it began, then I found myself on the edge of my seat, and then I found myself on my knees, and then I watched that thing either looking at it or on my knees, looking at it and on my knees. I had never seen God as R.C. Sproul laid him out in the holiness of God. And then it went from there to the Puritans. And they were used to generate, to show me what? Oh, there's so much more to this book than my little contemporary mind could ever grasp. So much more to the beauty of Christ. So I've spent the last almost 30 years of my life doing what? Studying the scriptures and then translating them out through the church.
Like a bitch.
Learning from people. Seeing more and more and more of Christ. So young people, apart from just some magnificent move of the Spirit here tonight, you're not just to be wound up, but you're to start a journey. You're to start a journey. This has been a long, hard journey. But with every new vision of Christ comes more strength.
I got one word of advice for you. Resign.
More fuel. More desire.
Dick, bitch.
More, 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 more. From where does passion come?
Bitch.
True passion. It comes from
I could have asked him up.
The person of Christ. I want to end by saying this. When we talk about going to heaven, and we talk about, you know, I don't want any of you to think that what we're talking about here is a 24/7
whoops
church service.
Ooh.
I love traveling. I don't like traveling, but I like going to strange places. I love to see beautiful things. I really do. Mountains, jungles.
Okay. With the
oceans. Marvelous things. I sometimes am angry that I don't live 800 years like the Antediluvians, because there's so many things I would like to study. But if you take all the most magnificent beauties of this world that most people give their life to see and never see, the other day I was in California and the sun was going down over the ocean, and some friends of mine said, look at that beautiful scene. And I said, and it was beautiful, but I thought I'd bring them all back to reality. And I said, that's not even God's trash can or heaven's trash can. Heaven will be beautiful. The new heaven and the new earth will be beautiful. Full of delight and full of joy. But if the creation, if the thing is beautiful, so much so that you would have to be supernaturally strengthened to endure its beauty, or it would fragment your mind. If it can be said of creation, then how much more of this glory and beauty emanating from Christ? And the further you go into Christ, the deeper you go into Christ, the bigger he gets, and the bigger the beauty, and the bigger the joy. I'm talking about wonders. Not just looking at an inanimate thing, or even an animate thing, but a person.
Oh,
a person so wonderful, so magnificent, that everything we have in the best of marriages is nothing compared to one look at him.
Stupid! Alright, fuck.
I talked to a young lady the
other day.
Someone ought to get a PhD.
What a dumbass. You ought to get another
PhD. I said, someone needs to write on just the beauty of God. You see, it's not just.
What a class one dumbass.
I saw our brother preaching on holiness, and he kept throwing in the word there, beauty, beauty.
That was stupid.
But I want you to grasp what he's saying. He's talking about the beauty of holiness. He's not just talking about, okay, we're all going to do right things. No, he's talking about actual beauty in a person. For God so loved the world that
move
he gave his only
put
son,
black ass
that whoever believes in him
right.
will not perish, but have
you fucking
eternal
bitch.
Life, everlasting life. This is eternal life. Knowing God and the Son who reveals him. That journey began, eternal life, and that journey to know God and the Son began the moment you were converted. Now, put blinders on. Go after Christ. Study him in the Word. Study him among men and women of reputation with regard to their love for Christ. And pray. Pray.
I still can't get over that dumbass losing his queen so stupidly.
Young people, there is a breaking through in prayer. Even until now, at times, prayer can be like a bronze ceiling. There is a breaking through. Where that
what
wall becomes more real
dumbass.
Than this one. There can be
fucking
a trisk.
Slut.
Christ.
Suck my slut.
No,
no, do you hear me?
Him,
suck my
so
slut.
So beautiful, you have to say, take your hand off me, lest I die. No more.
Fucking slut. Little bitch.
Now, I'm not saying anything Spurgeon wouldn't say or the Puritans haven't said. There's so much more to knowing him. In prayer, even his beauty can break your heart. But you said, I tried that. Martin Lloyd-Jones says, everybody begins well praying. Few persevere. There was an old preacher I knew. And if you ever asked him about prayer, how long should I pray? He'd say this, well, pray until you can pray. And then pray until you have prayed. Get on your knees. Say, I will not give you peace. Show me Christ. Let's pray.
Man, look at this horse manure. Man, look at this fucking horse
Please
shit.
Help us. We are very small. And very
Don't even think about it!
Please, Lord, in your providence, start these young people on a journey to seeking Christ. Bring godly men and women into their path. Bring good books, Lord. Create in them, O God,
oh,
a hunger
blessed,
to know
blessed,
your Son.
Blessed, 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 blessed,
oh, God.
Blessed, 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 blessed.
There's too much poverty, God, among your people when there's riches in Zion, O God.
In the precious holy word. In the precious holy word.
Oh, Lord. Please. In Jesus' name. Amen.
You dumbass. Fucking dumbass. And look at this horse shit. Get that damn knot out of here. Man, this is horse shit.
Let's go, Warriors! We did it! Jeff Bezos has had his balls off!
Man, that... Man, that one ugly ass
guy. Good job, guys! Apparently, this was put together by Chris Smalls. It was fired by Amazon. He used to work for them. And then people were like, getting COVID? And he was like, oh, shit. Amazon don't seem to be protecting us very well. At our warehouse, they seem more worried about profits than protecting their employees. And so he started a strike. And so they fired him. So he's like, I'm going to have to last laugh on you motherfuckers. So he worked his ass off. And he created his own union. Wasn't like the typical union. There's like a lot of already pre-made unions all across the United States where you can just plug into it. He's like, nah, we're going to do it from scratch. And he created his own. They had barbecues. And they invited Amazon employees. Gave tons of food and literature and talked to them. And they did it. So we didn't see this everywhere. Hopefully this is just the avalanche that is about to fucking happen. And of course, he had some badass shit to say. Here's some cold-blooded quotes. He said, we want to thank Jeff Bezos for going to space. Because while he was up there, we were organizing a union. Oh, snap. That's cold. That is cold. Don't say it's cold.
Dick sucker.
Hope he stays that way. Congratulations, Amazon! Fucking and the greatest part about this shit is watching all the conservatives melt down. Here's Jim Cramer! One of the most evil sons of bitches in the world. They gotta make you afraid of unions, folks. I mean, they're for the workers, obviously. They're gonna make sure workers actually make a living wage. And second richest man in the world, Jeff Bezos, might have to pay a dollar or two more to make sure his employees can live instead of having to be subsidized by the government. Which all these rich billionaires fucking are, but of course, the greedy uber capitalists have to scare you about the evils of unionization. So here he is going to claim that, oh my God, no one's going to work anymore if there's a union. It's at scale.
Well, we know that the union work rules are what everything is about. It's the same case with Starbucks, too. If you can't tell your employees when they work, then you're really not able to have much of an ability to be able to move product or move coffee. And I think that people, the unions,
man, look at this
in charge
shit.
Of time that you need to work. And that would be dreadful for, very dreadful for Andy Jassy.
Man, fuck this shit.
So and that's stupid. Just a U.S. picture, right? Yeah. They got Europe to think about as well.
You know, look, one of the problems was, you know, Starbucks does indeed have unionized
suck
places,
my dick.
The ones that they franchise, but if you can't control the work
fucking
rules,
bitch.
No one wants to work certain shifts. So you can say, listen, I'm not going to work that shift, and Amazon would not be able to say, yes, you must work it. So that's what's at stake with union is
the
time that you
bitch,
have.
I fucked up.
Our thanks to D.
It's not like a good faith argument. Oh my God, people aren't going to work.
That.
Yes, they are. That's bullshit. Amazon will still set the shift hours, and even if they didn't. You can always find somebody who wants to work a certain time period. Like, I used to work night shifts. That was great. I love that. I love having my days free, and you'll have some people that want to work the days. You'll have some people that want the weekends free, and you'll have some people that don't. They want the weekdays free. You'll always be able to find people to slot into those positions. This is obviously just incredibly bullshit fear-mongering, but, cry more, capitalist! Love to sin, and for some reason, I would say leftist, but fake leftist, Crystal Ball, who is a real human being that has that goofy-ass name, decided to attack AOC over this. Yeah, of all the people you could attack. Fucking AOC. So AOC is like, muscle, yeah. Hey, current vote totals. Yes, 15-18. No, 11-54. We're going to do it. Hooray. She's celebrating. It's cool. And so Crystal Ball.
Fucking bitch.
Who, in my opinion, is one of these Jimmy Dore fake leftists who's probably a Russian asset. Also, weasel-ass Cal Kalinske's girlfriend, shocker, decides to, yeah, why wouldn't you attack AOC?
I'm bringing that whore.
I mean, of all the fucking people you could attack, of all the Republicans who spend all their time ensuring that no one is ever unionized, of all the Christian shitheads who spend every waking hour make sure the working man is fucked. Why would you spend your time attacking one of the few people in all of Congress who is actually progressive, who's actually trying to evolve our society? Well, because you can make your own guesses about why this is. Is she being paid by the Russians, knowingly or unknowingly? I don't know. Like, is she just a piece of shit who wants to do the, oh, I'm attacking the left from the left thing because it's very lucrative to do so? Probably. But anyway, she's like, here's the guy who organized the union, dry, talking about how you left them high and dry. These are your constituents, and you couldn't be bothered to show up until they were on the cusp of victory. And they're not our constituents, she said. The warehouse isn't in my
district.
And maybe you should look at the map before claiming so. When scheduling conflict aside, we have requested oversight of investigations in Amazon, met with Amazon workers in the warehouse, and more. Hope you do more due diligence next time. I mean,
come on,
AOC is
bitch.
Like one of the main congresspeople that have pushed tirelessly for unionization. Literally no reason to attack her. And it went back and forth, and she basically accused AOC of not really worried about security, as she said, because she went to some kind of gala party, and then everybody's like, well, you know, they have
come
really
on,
good security at the gala.
Bitch.
So her saying she might be concerned about security doesn't mean that her going to the gala makes her a hypocrite when they have very good security there. So anyway,
come on, dumbass bitch.
Fuck off, Crystal! I'm on Team AOC! What? AOC is no longer a true progressive. Oh, God, you guys are so fucking stupid. Who is Jimmy Dore? Jimmy Dore, who spends all his fucking time doing nothing but helping the right take and maintain power, are they the ones that are true progressives? Like, how... You guys are so fucking stupid and gullible. It's, like, literally no wonder that the Don't Say Gay bill has a 52% approval rating from Democrats. You guys are just so fucking stupid. Yeah, Russian assets, the lot, I agree. Whether they know it or not, exactly what they fucking are. Smart up, dipshits! And, don't pee on me! God damn it! Fuck! This cat just came here and peed on me. Why did you do that? God damn it, Baby Yoda just walked over here and raised her ass and just sprayed me a little bit. Why not? In the middle of my show. You know what I needed? In the middle of this fucking show? Cat piss all over me. Thank you! How did you know, Baby Yoda? What do you get for the man that has everything? A little cat piss in the middle of a live show. Awesome. And so,
man,
anyway. Also, speaking of heroes, AOC! She pointing out rightfully how racist this goddamn country is. Mitt Romney says, worst domestic news today. I mean, we did find out today the unemployment rate is like historically fucking low, but the Biden administration will admit double or more the number of undocumented immigrants at the border starting May 28th. Oh no, the Browns. I can't believe the darkies are coming in. I mean, good God. Folks, we need immigration so bad.
Man,
we are not having enough babies to support our population anymore. We just aren't. People like me are like, yeah, kids, that sounds fucking awful. We have birth control now. We're making better decisions for ourselves and our lives and a lot of people not having babies. And we have an aging population. We need more immigration to support us. Unemployment is at like a historic low. There are so many fucking jobs we can't find anybody to do. Plus, immigration does nothing but boost the economy. They bring their own economy with them. It all fucking helps. The best geopolitical news of the day. The same as blah, 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 blah. Yeah, be afraid. Be afraid of the brownies and the immigrants. And of course, ALC rightly says, for those keeping score, when asylum seekers are European, politicians quickly recognize them as refugees. Yep. When they're from elsewhere, the same folks call them undocumented. Yep. Remember, seeking asylum is a legal right for all people, despite their prejudice. The more you know, yep. But they don't give a shit. If you're white, you lean Christian, bring them all in. But any other color, oh my God, it's the worst crisis in America. It's just, I don't know how you can deny the racism at this point, but they will. They always do.
No.
I know, right? Cat agrees with me. And I usually don't. I always say I usually don't get Joe Biden the benefit of it in the hero section, but I haven't kind of done that recently, and just saying, like, I hate to admit it, but Joe Biden is doing kind of a good job compared to, I mean, I know it's a low bar and shit, but jobs created by president average per month, I mean, Trump's the only person in modern times to leave office with less jobs than he started with. Bush almost did. You see, the Republican presidents always are bad for jobs, regardless of what they tell you, what they say. It's always bullshit. Democrats have always been better for job creation because economics doesn't work, and that's all Republicans are interested in. Tax cuts for billionaires and trillionaire companies, which don't trickle down. So Biden's actually doing a real fucking good job, it seems like, in certain instances. So, unsurprisingly, he has the lowest approval rating of, like, any president ever. He's going to lose miserably, because we're a goddamn garbage country who doesn't deserve good things. We deserve probably to burn to the fucking ground. Don't pee on me again, baby. Go away. I do not want your urine on me. No, thank you. And, speaking of heroes, you guys know about the Don't Say Gay Bill, right? The whole point of the Don't Say Gay Bill is to... get away from me. Is to have vague language in order to scare teachers into, and in no way even acknowledging that gay people exist. Or that anybody of any other gender, or that gender is the social construct, or that pronouns exist, right? And so, this hero
has an
amazing way to handle the situation. Attention, parents. A teacher from Palm Beach County, Florida shared this template with us. It is being shared among teachers to use for grades K through 3. And I guess it's a letter that he's sending home with the children that says, "Dear Florida parent / caretaker, the Florida House of Representatives has recently ruled that classrooms instructed by school personnel or third parties on sexual orientation or gender identity may not occur in kindergarten through grade 3 or in a manner that is not age-appropriate or developmentally appropriate for students," which means that's so vague, you can never tell what they might be suing you for. If you're a gay teacher, you can't say, "Hey, this is my husband." You have a student that has two dads, like Dave Rubin. Dave Rubin, his kid's going to go to these, I guess he doesn't live in Florida, but if he lived in Florida, if he goes to the schools, and they'd be like, "Hey, where's your mom?" The teacher can't say, "You've got two dads, got to keep his mouth shut." So anyway, the letter goes on to say, "To be in accordance with this policy, I will no longer be referring to your students with gendered pronouns. All students will be referred to as they or them. I will no longer use a gender title such as Mr. or Mrs. or make any reference to my husband / wife in the classroom. From now on, I will be using the non-gender titled MX. Furthermore, I will be removing all books or instruction referred to a person being a mother, father, husband, or wife, as these are gendered identities that also may allude to sexual orientation. Needless to say, all books which refer to a character will also be removed from the classroom. If you have any concerns about this policy, please feel free to contact your local congressperson." Awesome! Yep, love the fucking pushback. Exactly the way to fucking do this. Ridicule their stupidity. Mock them into extinction. And speaking of heroes, 40-time Jeopardy champion Amy Schneider was making the rounds. She got invited to the White House. Apparently Thursday was Transgender Day of Visibility. And so they asked her, "What do you think about all these bills that have been passed to harm gay people, not gay people, trans people, and oppress them?" And I thought her words were very needed in this time, especially for trans people feeling overwhelmed by the recent new attacks. It's got worse than ever somehow.
Suck my dick,
Mitch. But as she lets everybody know, I think it's going to be better.
Do you want to comment on all the bills we've seen around the nation?
They're really scary, and some of them in particular that are denying medical services.
Suck my dick, bitch.
Trans youth. Those are life-saving medical.
Come on, you fucking bitch.
They will, you know, those bills will cause the deaths of children, and that's really sad to me, and it's really frightening.
What is your message to students living in those states and young children?
Hang in there. I don't think that this is. I think that this backlash right now is temporary. I think that the country overall is on our side, getting more so every day. And I think it's not going to be too long before these sorts of bills are seen as no longer what we want to be.
I love her optimism. I think that will happen eventually. Still, though, these issues are winning issues for conservatives because people are still very, very easily panicked by trans people and still gay people in this country too. We're still a very homophobic country, unfortunately, even though we've made lots of fucking progress, undoubtedly. And speaking of heroes, apparently what the hell is this woman's name? I forgot her name. She was in Halloween. What is her name? So I tell you this woman's name right quick. I forgot. Anyway, she has a trans daughter. I could just look. Named Ruby Greymane. And she is a very good mom. What is her name? Mustang. Jenny Curtis, Jimmy Lee Curtis. Hey, I figured it out for you. Don't even tell me anymore. Anybody that tells me can go to hell. No, you did it. You did it, Spanky Weevil. You have to go to hell now. You have to go to hell. Anyway, Jamie Lee Curtis apparently is a very good and supportive mom to a transgender lady named Ruby Greymane, and I love to say it. You know, Jamie Lee Curtis had her on. You're already saying it. All of you motherfuckers telling me, haha, too late, too late. Jamie Lee Curtis has had her own history with transphobia. I don't know if that's what I would call it. Anyway, I heard about this rumor
growing up,
I'm sure you guys did too, where she was constantly made fun of because they claimed that she had both sex organs, which is not true at all. But she was roundly mocked and ridiculed, like, for her entire career over this rumor. Like, even if it were true, it would be a bad thing. But it was used to, like, disparage her.
Fucking bitch.
And so she's dealt with this bullshit firsthand. And I guess all it did was make her a better person. So good to see it. Good on you, hero Jamie Lee Curtis. Proud of. Oh yeah, her her daughter said,
"Shut the mom is the most supportive." Up. Fucking cunt. Grow fucking cunt. Suck my dick. Fucking bitch. You fucking cunt.
Fucking bitch.
on, you fucking bitch. Play the fucking songs, fucking bitch. Bitch.
Fucking bitch.
Man, this is fucking bullshit. Suck my dick, man. Pancakes all night long! Fucking bitch. Come on. Cry, fucking bitch. No. Stupid! I gotta get rid of these fucking ponies. Come on, dick. Come on, dickhole. Night. I hate them damn nights. Suck my dick, bitch. Fucking bitch. Dick, you fucking nigger. Fucking nigger. Shit colored fucking nigger. No. Come on, shit colored nigger. No. 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 Dancing, 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 dancing. Don't even think about it. No. Come on, you fucking nigger. Fucking bitch. Shit, you bitch. Come on, shit, cold nigger. Don't even think about it! Fucking nigga. No. Please, fucking nigga. Come on, you whore! Suck my dick, bitch. Fucking bitch. Suck my dick, bitch. Fucking bitch. Fucking bitch. Suck my dick, bitch. Fucking bitch. No. Suck my dick, bitch. Come here, you fucking bitch. Come on, you fucking bitch. You fucking bitch. Suck my... God, son of a bitch. Fucking bitch. Fucking bitch. Come on, you fucking bitch. Come on, you fucking nigger. You fucking faggot ass duck queer dyke. Come on, you fag. Come on, you fucking, you motherfucking spick ass wop. Fucking jap ass honky. You fucking jap ass jap honky motherfucker. Fucking jap. Come on, you fucking jap. You fucking kike. Come on, you fucking raghead. Come on, you fucking kike raghead Arab. Fucking kike ass dyke. Come on, you fucking kike ass dyke. Fucking porch monkey. Fucking Mexican. Fucking spick. Come on, you damn kike. Fucking kike. Fucking kike. You fucking nigger. Come on, nigger. No. Come on, nigger. Come on, kike. I just eared his rook. Like cutting off his right ear. Not cutting off his left ear. I just eared his rook. You fucking nigger. Nah. Don't even think about it, bitch. I got more where that come from. Dyke. Thank you. Now I need to freeze these fucking pieces. Now I need to free these fucking pieces. I'm fucking his at lunch. Yeah, you better take that damn whore. You know what's good for you, fucking bitch. Stupid bitch. Come on, you fucking bitch. Come on, bitch. Fucking bitch. No. Come on. Come on, dickhole. Come on, dick sucker. Come on, you fucking dick sucker. Fucking dick sucker. Spit, 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 spit. Damn it! Son of a bitch. Fucking bitch. Because you just fucked up. Suck my dick. I fuck his hole! With the clue! And she's got clue arms. She smells like a clue! That part of her arm smells like clue spit smell. Man, let's dick one more person up. Suck my slut. Let's dick one more person up. Let's dick this guy up. I'll dick him up. Fucking slut. Suck my dick, bitch. Let's dick this motherfucker up. Fucking bitch. I'll dick him up.
I close my eyes.
I'll dick him up. I'll dick him up. I will dick him
there
up.
There it was.
Fucking
soul
bitch.
Traveling.
Fucking bitch.
And there
you stupid motherfucker.
Right before me. The land of Utopia.
Man, I'm fucking this guy up. I'm dicking this guy up. I am dicking him up. Big time. I'm dicking him up. I'm dicking this dick up.
I closed my eyes.
Let's dick this guy up. Okay, I dicked up his rook.
Utopia.
Now I'm gonna dick up his pawns.
I'll dick those pawns up.
Good for it. I'll dick those damn pawns up.
And there it was.
Come on, I'll dick that pawn up. Fucking bitch. Fucking bitch. Yo. Dick up this fucking poem. Dickhole. Sucker. Thank you. damn it. God damn it! Goddamn bitch. Fucking bitch. fucking bitch. Come on, you fucking bitch. Closing in on his asshole. There's only one place you can go. Spit, 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 spit. I'll put your black ass for stalling. You fucking nigger. If he was on this damn truck, I'm gonna buck his black ass. Fucking bitch. Fucking cunt. I fucked his whole fucking bitch. God, when was you growing? You're so good to me. What? Stole like a bitch. Tried to tell you, but you look at me.
like maybe I'm an angel underneath, innocent and sweet. Yesterday I cried, must have been relieved to see the softer side. I can understand how you'd be so confused. I don't envy you, I'm a little bit of everything. I'll roll into one, I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child,
I'm a motherfucker.
Start to make you nervous, and I'm going to extremes. Tomorrow I will change, and today won't mean a thing. I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child, I'm a mother, I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. I do not feel ashamed. I'm your help, I'm your dream, I'm nothing in between. You know you wouldn't want it any other way.
Ha! dumbass. Maybe I'm a fucking dumbass.
You bitch.
I see a dick in your future. Fucking bitch. Watch this shit. I'm finna fuck your butt. Hold on. Ooh. Come on, bitch, move. Bitch. I'm getting a thumbs down this asshole for being a poor sport bitch. Fucking bitch. Let's get ready to do. Okay. Let's go back to the clue.